night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone. Late night when you need my love.
What is up? Welcome back to another video. It's me, your girl Gina, short for Real Gina. I know I have a lot of new subscribers here, so if you're watching this video, hey, how's it going? If you're a returning subscriber, what is up? Today's video is going to be a tutorial on this look right here. Of course, all of my videos are makeup tutorials. One day I'm going to branch out and do a different video. If you guys have ideas of what you want me to do moving forward, then comment them down in the comment section below. But while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how I created this look right here. This is the makeup I ended up wearing on Labor Day. So if you guys are interested in it, just keep on watching.
All right, you guys, we back and we're going to jump right into the tutorial. We're taking the OG, the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. Honestly, one of my favorite palettes. I don't know why I don't use it more. But anyway, we're going to be taking this chocolate shade right here and we're going to start buffing that all over the lid. This look is literally easy peasy lemon squeezy. It's a bunch of blending, and essentially what you want to do on the top of the lid is just create a brown smoky eye. So using that color I was showing you guys previously, I'm just going to start blending that all over the mobile lid with a big blending brush. And if you're wanting to do this look, but maybe you're wanting to change the color, honestly, if you change the color to blue, green, purple, black, orange, brown, it doesn't matter. This technique will work with any color, literally.
Late night when you need my love. Call me on my cell phone.
After I have the brown blended to my liking, I'm going to take this shade up at the top, and this shade is actually called Silk Cream, I think. The names of the shades are actually on the back of the palette, which I think is genius because some of the times they put that little clear slip in there, and everybody knows that clear slip gets thrown away. So the name of these colors are actually on the back of the palette. I think that shade that I hit pan on is called Silk Cream, and it's one of my favorite colors in the entire palette. Imagine that, a little nude shade happens to be my favorite color in this entire gigantic palette. And now we're going to go ahead and start jumping into the skin. I'm using my foundation brush just to apply a light layer of foundation to my skin. If you guys are wondering what foundation combination I'm using, don't even ask, because at this point I have no clue. I had to mix two foundations to get this shade, and honestly I wasn't all that impressed with it when I was first putting it on, but of course I made it work in the end. So just take your favorite foundation and then apply that, and then we're going to move on to concealer. Now we're going to go ahead and jump into concealer. I'm using the Juvia's Place concealer. I don't know why I don't use this concealer more, because this concealer is actually really good. Unlike the foundation that Juvia's Place has, the concealer is quite hydrating. It's full coverage and it doesn't make you feel cakey under the eyes. So I'm applying the Juvia's Place concealer first, and then I'm going, of course, with my e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer in the shade Deep Olive right underneath that. And then I'm going to take two brushes and I'm going to go ahead and start blending that out. Starting first with my Eco Tools brush, I'm going to use that to blend out the concealer closest to the eye. Then I'm going to go in with my Morphe. I think the number on the brush is either 202 or 405. I always get the foundation brush and the concealer brush that I use mixed up. But anyway, this is the brush I'm using, as you can see here, and I'm using that brush to blend out the e.l.f. concealer. Such a good combination. Now I'm using the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer in the shade Rich Ebony for my contour. I'm taking that along the cheeks. I think I'm going to do a little bit on the forehead and also on the nose. And then I'm going to go in and blend that out. After I blend that out, I think I go ahead and set my face off camera. Of course, I use the iHeart Revolution setting powder in the shade Banana. So I did that off camera, and then we're going to jump into our bronzing and contouring. Look at that skin, you guys, it's coming along so well. So starting off with this powder, I actually don't use this powder often. So when I went in, I felt like it was a little bit too harsh. But this is the Black Radiance powder. I think it's in the shade like Caramel or Mocha or something like that. And then I'm using my Morphe Glamour Bronze in the shade Phantom. And I'm applying that over top just to soften everything up a bit. And then I'm using the BH Studio Pro Powder. This is in the shade 250. I like to use 250 under the eyes. And then I like to use 255 all over. Considering I wasn't really sure about that foundation combination, I think my skin turned out quite well. I'm jumping back into the eyes just because I want to go ahead and finish those up. So we're going to use the Essence Super Precise Black Eyeliner to go ahead and do a decent wing. I say decent because you know how it is when you're doing your wing liner and you say, oh, I just want a little short, cute, small wing, and then you keep messing with it until you have a freaking massive wing liner. So I'm doing my best to just do like a decent type of small liner, and I'm going to do that on both sides, of course. And I get so many people who ask me to do a eyeliner tutorial, and honestly, you guys, the key to a good eyeliner, because trust me, I still have my days where I'm like, WTF, is to just practice, like everything in life. There was a quick little clip there of me putting on mascara, and then now I'm just filling in my lips with the NYX Butter Gloss. If you guys are ever wondering what's on my lips, it's probably this mixed with like three other lippies, truth be told. Now I'm going to take this lip pencil. This is by Nikki K, and it says that this color is red, but when it goes on, it always looks like hot pink to me. So I'm using that in the waterline, and then I'm going to take my Juvia's Place Saharan Volume 2 Blush Palette, and I'm going to use that pink shade to further smoke out the bottom lash line. I just felt like the brown wasn't enough, so I wanted to give myself like a little pop, and I'm glad I chose the pink because the pink was literally perfect. But you could honestly choose any color to go on the bottom lash line. You could do white, you could do black if you wanted to go sultry, you could do yellow, orange, blue, green, purple, it doesn't matter. And then here's a special little sneak peek for you guys. These are the lashes I'm wearing today. Of course, these are by me. These are luxury extensions in the shade Exclusive. These will be in the launch. So when I originally launched my luxury extensions lash brand, these were in there. And honestly, guys, you're going to see once I put this on, they are so fucking bomb. How could I not bring this back to my lash line? I had to bring these back. And the packaging you saw me use, that's not the official packaging. The official packaging is like a marble copycat type of packaging. So yeah, but look at this, you guys. I'm just making sure they are placed correctly. So freaking bomb. You can't tell me that these aren't the most bomb lashes you've ever seen. Period. Okay. Well, this is pretty much the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye.